Hey, what's up? Welcome, everybody. Today's topic is pretty interesting. I'm working on some spirit walls. These are things that you have to use your meditation or a cactus, and these walls will open up a lot like a bombable wall would. This is actually a place where a bombable wall used to be, actually. This is now converted into a spirit wall, so bombs will not open it. So that's the goal, is to turn that into a wall where you have to use your meditate to open it, or cactus. This is an existing bombable wall as it was. Those are what those are. So yeah, I'm working on that today, and also one more type of wall where you can use a killabomb to open it. So you have to have the killabombs, which are rare. You barely, you usually find them at the end of the game. So those are kind of special. They're only going to be used in a couple places. So this is kind of neat having it all. There's so many kinds of new walls. There's the backtracking wall. There's the spirit wall, the killabomb wall, and this really add a lot of cool, interesting elements to the game. I'm sure this is going to really help the mystery of it all, the secret, the exploration. Oh, this is what I love this game for. Okay, so the trick here is basically all I have to do is use the meditate, and then that opens the wall. I've already got everything prepped. All the hard work, the programming work is all done for this. The most important part was adding all these new types of doors. That was pretty critical. I had to make sure the whole game didn't break or it didn't change the whole game. The way the dungeon generator works and the overworld generator works, but especially the dungeon generator. Do they place the exact same doors? So I was here comparing it to old versions, stuff like that, and everything's all good. So anyways, the hard work is done, and now it's just time to do the fun part, which is the tiny little implementation where all you do is use your meditate and it opens the wall. So all right, so I've already got it set up so it can this open secret wall function can pass in a door type, and now I just need to, whenever you use the meditate, it needs to open secret walls with the spirit door type. So, that would be use meditate, and I think this would be. Yeah, this would fall under the do reveal thing because actually, let's make sure that works. If I sit here and use meditate, that should do a tiny little psychedelic effect and reveal the secret wall. Yeah, cool. Okay, so the reveal is there, and then it turns the wall like half transparent, but it's still solid. So if I come up here and trying to get up there, it's been revealed to me, but I haven't been able to activate that wall or get past it. Bombs still shouldn't work. Cool. Okay, now when we do the reveal delay, activate all, activate spirit. Here we go. Secret system. Open secret wall. Center. This doesn't matter. Radius. Oh, actually, I guess we could do the center of the screen and then just the whole screen. That probably would not have to mess with any systems. So that should be just. Oops. What? A dot area size times a half. Radius, this is in tiles. Let's make this really big. Right? It's the entire width. Yeah. Okay. Actually, technically, this should be the greater value of a dot width and a dot height, but I know width is always greater, but anyways, that'll make it more future proof, I guess. Door type is K door spirit. All right, we're opening up spirit walls now. Let's see if this works. Man, it's been really quiet on the chat always, like the past like 3 weeks a month when the stream starts. I think Twitch really changed something a couple weeks ago or a month or two ago. There's always people chatting like right away for the past 3 years. But now, whenever I start a stream, there's like nobody here for a while. I don't get it. Okay, we meditate, reveal. It didn't work. Okay. Well, I guess we'll just debug it. Find out why that didn't work. This is exciting. It's so exciting to have more secret possibilities, more ways. And especially something that incorporates the meditation and the cactus more. It's very core to the game, the message of the game. All right, so what do we get for center? Should be 210, 120, but we did get a Z of 5. Whatever the heck that means. All right, radius 21, type spirit. All right, let's find out what happens. Open secret wall. We need to scan for all secret components. Continue to hear. Okay, so the type we're looking for is spirit. These secret components should have door type spirit. Yeah, good. And, oh, and they're already revealed as well. Oh, it might be this position then. See, I'm not going to be able to see the distance squared. But, well, okay, what's the position? It has a position, so that's good. That means, do we fail here? Yeah. Distance squared to center. Huh. Okay, well, we need to see what that value was. And let's make it a vec2. And here we're going to store the disk squared. So maximum distance squared is radius. No! That confused me. All right. That's not radius in tiles. It's radius in actual pixels. Okay. That was, what was wrong with it? All right, we need not max of a dot width, a dot height. This is max of area size dot x or area size dot y. And we probably don't need Xcode anymore. Whenever I say that, I always need Xcode right after that. So I've learned to not close Xcode for a second. I only use it for debugging. All right, let's meditate. Okay, well, we hit the breakpoint anyways, might as well look into it. Okay, so the distance squared, 17,824, which is 133. All right, and the max distance squared is the radius, which is 420. This time it should work. Yeah. All right, let's let this run. Salad, aloha. How are you doing today? Aloha, it reminds me of, saying aloha reminds me of Toe Jam and Earl. Nice. Okay, so that worked, but it didn't do the screen shake or the smoke or anything else you would get from an explosion. So I want it to feel like an explosion, like you use your meditate skill or your cactus, and it just feels like you just exploded the wall with somehow, like actually using a bomb. Oh yeah, man. They sure did. The secret level. In Toe Jam and Earl. Aloha. Do you remember the secret level? Level zero? All right, good. We're on the way. So what is it about? Let's close that. We don't need Xcode anymore. Now, okay. Now we need to do the same kinds of things that this would do. Does this return a bool? It does. I can tell whether this worked. Okay, so I could actually, yeah, let's do it that way. Instead of reworking the way the normal system works, I'll rework the way this new system works. Oh, you never played it much? Oh, I hear you. It was a classic amongst my friends growing up, my close, like, personal, you know, core group of friends. We played Toe Jam and Earl a lot. So it reminds me of those times playing, you know, playing games when we were kids. Oh man, your connection's bad, huh? Sad face. What you working on today? Oh yeah, you didn't have one? Oh yeah. I didn't have one either, but my friends had one. We always played on theirs. So if we open a secret wall, we want to do a bomb explosion and screen shake. Yeah, the audio chip's pretty good on it, huh? It was. I liked how it had three buttons, too. It's like, wow, three buttons. I think that's in explosive damage. Or, no, actually it's in mood explode. This is where it does all its particles and... There we go. So we'll do, yeah. Lens shake, roof debris. What's duration in this value? That. Point six. Okay, so we got some lens shake, roof debris. Rumble. What's this whole factor about? Oh, that's how far away you are from the explosion. So let's keep factor at just... Wait, there's factor and overall factor. Let's get those. RuneWord, what's up, man? Yeah, I actually played this at PAX, the new Toe Jam and Earl, and I was quite happy with it. Yeah, I love Toe Jam and Earl on the Genesis too, man. Yeah, so I got to play Toe Jam and Earl. It's based on the original, and I liked it. Oh, yeah, Twitch. I was wondering why there's so few people chatting right at first on Twitch lately, at least on this stream. It's like a month ago, maybe 2 months ago, something changed, and then all of a sudden nobody was chatting at first. It's like people aren't getting the notifications anymore or something like that. I don't know. Yeah, it does. Yeah. I wonder, I think it will, yeah, I think it actually kind of, they kind of fixed a few of the problems almost that the first one had. They're not really problems. You know, the first game was just kind of like a different era. But I think they kind of improved a few things too. Oh, it's just lurkers? All right, it's just lurking. Okay, so yeah, we don't need the factor. So the factor is just one, and then this is based on the psychedelic strength. That could also just be one. Doesn't matter. All right, so let's make that just 1.0 minus 0.8, which is 0.2 times overall factor, which is 0.2. Which is the strength, rumble the controller for only 0.2. Let's make that 0.5. Because did the factor get more than one? I don't know. Disc squared? I don't know. Okay, so we're rumbling the controller. We're doing some roof debris. We add some shake. But what else? Deal damage? No. 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 Smoke. We definitely need some smoke. That'll really help. It creeps you out? Yeah. It doesn't creep me out. I see it this way. Like, I've watched many streams myself, you know, and it's like... I lurk a lot as well because A, Sometimes I'm not in the mood to type, you know? B, I'm typically doing it a lot on a mobile device. So I'm like trying to watch somebody's stream while I'm doing something else or something like that. And I don't really have time to type, you know? But it's still interesting to watch the person stream. And then C, sometimes you just have nothing to say, you know? It's not like that, from at least from my own perspective, lurking myself, it's like I have good reasons to lurk. And I know all y'all have good reasons to lurk too. Yeah, it is. You can't really type that well or that quickly on mobile. You can't really share links that fast and all that kind of stuff either. If you want to go get a link, you have to like close the app sometimes. Okay, so yeah, we want to do a dust smoke. No energy wave, just the dust and the smoke though. So do we have the entity position? That's the hero. So the dust and the smoke has got to be somewhere near the secret components that are getting removed and all that. Where, how are we going to know exactly where? Wait. I think, do these secret components actually get removed in OpenSecret Wall? Whoa, holy crap. Yeah, Crawl's an awesome game. No, it's definitely not an insult at all. Crawl is definitely, I would consider Crawl one of my inspirations because the art is so good for Crawl. And the code as well. I bought Crawl like 4 years ago. I've been playing Crawl for a long time. I think it's an excellent game. And no, it's not using the same engine. Crawl is using Unity. They use Unity to do their engine. I use an engine called Cocos 2DX. I think what you're seeing there from a similarity standpoint is the visual style of the pixel art is similar. And it's also similar to like Sword and Sorcery and other types of games recently, like that use bigger pixels. That's a real hallmark of, you know, these kinds of pixel art games these days. Songbringer is just one of those games that's a pixel art game these days. You know what I mean? But also, one of the things I really respect about Crawl is their animation. Their animation is so good. And Barney, the guy that does the animations for Crawl, he shares a lot of videos. So if you want to be an animator or if you want to get better at animating or making pixel art and stuff like that, definitely check out some of Barney's videos because they're a great way to like absorb someone else's amazing skills with something really quickly, because Barney's not only is an amazing animator, but he's also a pretty good teacher and seems like a pretty fun guy. So I'd definitely like to shake his hand one day and say thanks. Also, Dave, the programmer from Powerhoof that makes Crawl, seems like a cool guy too. So, anyways, that duo definitely got some respect for them. OpenSecret Wall. The sound effects are pretty good too, right? And the music. And also, their freaking trailers are incredible. I love their trailers. And that voice in their trailers is so sick. Yeah. Oh, so does it remove the secret component? That's what I'm wondering. It does not. Oh wait, it does change it to be secret open. Okay, so what we need to do basically is go through all the secret components, find a center point. So we need to do you know what? This should be a secret system function. Okay, secret system. We need a new function. This is called Static float. Wait, no. Static vec2. Yeah. Get secret open cent. You know what? Get center point of all secret components of the given type. So there, now I'm just going to pass in basically secret open, and it will do that. Okay, so let's just mock this function up, or do this function here for now. Okay, so we're looping over all secret components. We start with a count of 0. We give it a vec2 position that we're just going to keep adding to and then divide by the count afterwards. Oh, sweet. You finally got it? Huh. Yeah. What's up, Boy Gnarks? Am I a wizard? I don't know. You tell me. I'm not wearing my wizard hat right now. Oh, it's going to support 4 players? Dude, that's cool. I didn't know that. So they had it playable at PAX, and they had 2 controllers out. Luckily, when I started playing, this other dude came up and started playing it with me. So I got to experience it how you would with somebody else, which is kind of the point of Toe Jam and Earl. It's not really that much of a single player game. Well, I guess it is. It's both single player and co-op, but it's really, there's a focus on the co-op, is what I'm trying to say. Okay, so we need to get the position. Actually, we can just go pause, plus equals. I think we can use position components. Get, I think it's just get actually. Oh, and that gets into a pause though. So we need a V3F pause. Okay, so now we're adding to pause plus equals P. And then at the end, pause divided by equals float count. And then return pause. The old one? What are you talking about, the old one? Which one's the old one? Did they release the old one on Steam? Oh, right. Okay, so back to where we were. Why is this giving me an error here? Oh, you can't divide by? You can multiply by, but you can't divide, I think. That's what the... Does that work? Yep. Okay, so make this a safe div. Always divide safely. What? They do have the old one on Steam? Yeah, I didn't care for the second game either. I don't think it was very well received. Oh, or the third game. Or the 3D game. Didn't they make a 3D game about it recently? Didn't they make a recent 3D game about it? Or was that what turned out to be this current one we're getting now? Can't remember. Okay, so we've got get center point, which means we just go back to... input system. Okay, so now we can get the center point. So, auto... center equals secret system get center point. Why am I using a Vec2 here? This is just wrong. Change my mind. What? Oops. Secret system. Let's make that a Vec3. It's just kind of pointless to use Vec2s, except when dealing with Cocos 2DX. Because one day I'll be like, wait, what if I want to change this and make this the third dimension? Yeah, there was a third one. Wasn't that the 3D one? And my Vec3 class can do dividing. There, this whole function feels better now. What? All right, so we're getting the center point of K door secret open. There. So now instead we can use this for this center there to color. What color for the smoke? Ooh, what color was that? Oh, color starts at white, and then if it's fire or whatever. No, wait, where does it change the color? Oh, yeah, it gets the item color if it's a. Right, okay, so we'll just use white. All right, so we should be able to compile now. And all this is gonna do is basically, if the secret wall is open, then it does this, all these animations to make it feel more cool when you do this. And in fact, I should also check the sounds. Make sure this is feeling all good. So we're gonna meditate. And it's going to open up this secret wall with an explosive explosion. Okay, that was weak sauce. Weak sauce on the sound, at least. We need a sound effect for that. In fact, I think I'll just use the regular explosive sound for that, because that's kind of what I'm trying to go for here, is like this feels like this wall just explodes. Oh, it was on the original Xbox. Oh, okay, so I know they had a Kickstarter recently as well, and I'm pretty sure they succeeded with that Kickstarter, and I think that might actually be what ended up being the current game that they're releasing now. I don't know. I haven't followed it too closely. What was I looking for here again? Dust, smoke. Oh, the sound effect, which is probably just bombs. Yeah, it's the bomb release. Okay. So this would be profile get bomb play sound release. Cool. It worked, but it's like there wasn't enough delay before it happened. The rhythm felt a little wrong. Besides, the reveal secrets needs to take a second. So basically, this needs to be its own. This needs to be its own schedule thing. So we'll do a cons float reveal delay, and also let's call this an open delay. Whatever. Another like 3 seconds. And we do all this stuff where you open the secret walls. And we also need to check. See, we're not using this hero. Right? We compress that a little bit. And then compress this. Okay, so yeah, whenever we do one of these, we're checking to see if it's the same area and also that the player is still sitting before doing this. And then so this will be open spirit walls, and this is reveal secrets. So that gives the reveal secrets animation a second to run, right? Actually 3 seconds to run before it opens some spirit walls. So let's see how this feels this time. Maybe we might need more smoke and dust too. That might help. Okay, that was a little too much delay. Is there not enough? I don't think there's enough smoke. That's the big thing. That's another thing here. Count. Let's just double that at least. Let's quadruple that. Some amount of smoke. Make sure there's a ton of it. There's a little less, actually. Thank you. think it needs to play the psychedelic sound, actually. Whenever you successfully meditate, I think that's what's missing here. There's not a sound when it's like, you just meditated successfully. There's something here that you can, that you did because of that. Here, play, kid play sounds psychedelic.wave. I guess that is the appropriate way to do this. Such a big sound. No, screw that. This needs to be loaded beforehand. Put that in common. Sounds. Psychedelic. Whoops. Psychedelic. So back to the other input system. Change. Once we reveal stuff, play the secret sound. See how that feels. It's like it was really missing some kind of sound effect that connected you to you're doing something spiritual. Cool. Now that it has a sound, it actually can have a little more delay. Yeah, now I just need and more. Wait, what? I just feel like there needs to be more delay again. Oh, you know what? These should not be revealed. It's like it's changing the Wait. No, it's not that. It's like, okay, so what's happening is the reveal secrets function here is taking those secret walls, and once it's like, oh, you use the meditate, then it goes in and makes them transparent, semi-transparent. So basically when the secret system opens a secret wall and needs to reassert that it has full opacity. Here, Secrets to Debris goes and no, that's where it sets blocks. Not there. Not Jib Talk. This is a secret component of the given type. Opening a secret wall. Okay, I think this is okay to put this here. Oh, ref render equals entity. Actually, let's use entity get. Now we need to use render ready entity get render component id if not render empty render dot set and render dot sprite dot set opacity. Okay, there, we're just assuring full opacity when we explode the wall. I think what was happening there is it got transparent and then we exploded the wall, so it didn't seem as substantial because the wall was partially transparent. I hope. It's just not feeling substantial enough. Oh, we got to stop actions as well. I think that had a fade action on it. Kukuriku, what's up, man? It's going really well. I'm having lots of fun on Songbringer. How you doing? They still got transparent. You're fine? That's good to hear. Yeah, you doing Ludum Dare? When is that one? When's that coming up? What is it that's still... Okay, so Reveal Secrets, I think, is... Wait, isn't this the Delete Secret Entities? April 21st, nice. Salad, cool, you gonna try your hand at it? Nice. Maybe? Cool. It might be that. So after it opened the secret wall, okay, this is more simple then. Basically, when it deletes secret entities, it needs to ensure full opacity. Oh, that's not it either. It's not delete secret enemies, it's reveal. God, what is the thing? Oh, we gotta find what's. I think it's this, reveal secret exits. Reveal secret walls, there. If secret revealed or secret type is empty, or secret type equals K door secret. If we've already opened it, wait a minute. This might actually break it. Because we're. Let's convert. Is this con this is what does it? Whoa, 3 games in a year? Congratulations, that's amazing. Wow, and before that, your last game was 2007. Dude, congratulations. Oh my God, what? Yeah, if the secret is already open, don't animate it as a reveal. I think this should work. It, still did it. Okay, I think it's this. Just start playing process of elimination to figure out what the hell is causing that fade. Oh, yeah. Oh, it's the bigger projects you have problems with? I hear you. I hear you. I hear what you're saying, man. It seems to be a common thing among. Game developers in general, that a lot there's like a lot of people that have that problem where they can't really like stay on a project for long. What do you call that? What is that? You just get you what is it what is that called when you just can't really stay with a long-term project? You prefer another way of wording it is you prefer to create short-term projects, you know? That's your style. They are. They're a very big investment. Steve Tramby! What's up, buddy? Ennui? Yeah. Probably. Squirrel syndrome? What's that? Okay, I need to see if it didn't reveal. Space my name! What's up? Commitment issues? Yeah. Yep, that's what's doing it. Working on Project A. Oh, look, a squirrel. Yeah, being prepared to work on those times when you're really sick of working on a project. So you don't prefer that. Oh, okay. You wish you could make something big enough to sell, but I'm having squirrel syndrome. You adopted it. Nice. Squirrel syndrome. Gosh, I wish I could help you out with some advice, but I learned recently that all advice is bad. I learned that from Rami Ismail, so I'm gonna try not to give advice as much. Was actually a pretty good talk though, from Rami Ismail and 4 other people, some really great industry veterans. It was a GDC talk. What was it called? I'll think of it here in a second. There we are, nearly done. Oh wait, I just had an idea. Let's try that out. That's just a new framework, that's all. Start another side project. Right, I totally know about this is like my life right here. You have issues working on long-term projects? Yeah, you jump around. Grip Gary, what's up? Okay, I know I said I was not going to try and give any advice, but how about I offer perhaps a solution that might work? This is kind of there's oh man, there was a really great video on it recently about working on like when you're it was called oh The 7 Habits of Highly Effective Artists. It's a great talk. You should check it out if you're an artist or even you know what I think it applies to all of game development. This is a great talk, but basically the point is that or one of the tips for working being a really highly effective artist is to work on one thing, give it a break. Work on the next thing, give that other thing a break, and work kind of like in a spiral, like in a circle. You work on things, give them a good break. You like give yourself that time to relax and forget about that thing you were working on for a while, and then you come back to it with fresh eyes. And that kind of works in with art, it works with programming, it works with music, and maybe that works to solve that thing where you have this sort of issue where long form games are difficult to complete because maybe you're working on one thing too much, too long. I don't know. Like working on smaller projects? Yeah, or skill improvement projects? Yes, these are good things to have, right? Yeah, a different area, a different level, a different part of your game engine, something like that. Right, yeah. It's when you're like, this is the absolute truth. This is all the advice you'll ever need. Yeah. Fibonacci's project? Yes, that's a good way to do it. That's a good way to look at it. It's like the Fibonacci sequence of game development. You're constantly just adding one and two, and two and three, and then three and five. Five and eight. I do this with Songbringer very much. Very much on a daily basis. So I'm constantly working on one thing in the morning, another thing while I'm streaming and doing stuff in the afternoon, and then another thing at night. Or maybe I will work on one thing all for a single day, but then the next day I'll be working on something else. So it's very refreshing. It's like, okay, cool. One day that's done. Or maybe, if I work an entire day and I don't finish that thing, maybe I still will go and work on something else so I can give that one thing a break. I don't Golden ratio, your time. There you go. Treating your long-term project as a bunch of short-term projects. Yeah, it's been working wonders. Yes, excellent. And then, oh, he has a hierarchy of projects. So he has a main game and then a secondary game and then some side projects to toy with. That's cool. Fibonacci salad? Salad is composed of the salad that was served yesterday and 2 days ago. This totally makes sense. I didn't know this was an Urban Dictionary phrase. What's up, internal static void? I'm using Vim. I use Xcode as well, but only for debugging. I do all my editing in Vim. Speaking of debugging, I gotta figure out why this doesn't. So I'm doing a render sprite run action. I'm rendering it on the secret components render component and setting secret revealed. And this happens in reveal secrets. What calls reveal secrets again? Figure that out. Now you want salad. Salad's good. I used to hate salad, but now I'm really a salad lover. My lady makes some amazing salads. She's really good at making salad taste awesome. It's like, what? This is salad? Really? Oh, okay, this is called manually from the systems. Okay, so when we're revealing secrets there. Okay, so we reveal secrets first. It's running an action. Okay, I'm really confused as to why it didn't work when I wrote that code to stop the render component running its action. That's really weird. Okay, we've got this little bit of code. This is good to like not do the secret open. Let's put that back in. And then when we open a secret wall, we'll just have to reassert that it's opaque again. Take out salad. Yeah, there's like some really great ones in San Francisco. I'm in here in Oakland. We don't really have it, but it's, yeah, I like ranch, but it's weird if you eat it out of the jar. So I pour it in a bowl and add some lettuce and veggies. That's awesome. So awesome, Steve. Steve, how was your winter, man? There's been a lot of snow out your way, right? Hasn't there been like, oh wait, I'm assuming. I don't know. Have you guys had good weather? Like good winter? Because we had a crazy good winter here in California. We've been getting so much rain. All our mountains have tons of snow. Yeah, cool. Salad's just a vehicle for salad dressing. Okay, so the secret wall becomes opaque if it wasn't. All right, well, let's do this again. Render equals entity get render component. Maybe I was using the wrong id. Oh, maybe that code was not even getting called or getting hit. Yeah, I should set a breakpoint here to make sure this actually works. Open Xcode. All right, so am I using the right id? This is a secret component. We've guaranteed that it's the secret component that we want to open, the secret type. So this is like a spirit wall secret component. It's the wall. We make sure it's in the distance. We've got the door. Just make sure the render is fully opaque. So if not, render.empty. My God. All right, there. Then render, stop all actions. Wait a minute. Is that actually render.set opacity? Wait, render dot, that was a sprite. Set opacity to be 255. And also, I guess the blend function should be default. Maybe that was getting set. Okay, so there. We need a breakpoint here and also a breakpoint when the animation starts. It's nice all year? Yeah, sweet. You like snow and sun? Yeah. Colorado. Wow. That's great. That's really nice weather. Yeah, out here we rarely get, or at least on the coast here in California, we rarely get nights below freezing. But further north in Northern California on the coast, they get freezing, but definitely in the in our inner, you know, in the inner, what do you call that? The inner valley. Inland, that's what it is, inland. Okay, where's that other thing? Here. Okay, so when you got two breakpoints, this is just gonna confirm that the animation is actually running before that other thing, and also that this is stopping the action, setting the correct opacity, and then that all works. So what I'm trying to do is make it when you explode this wall, it's fully opaque, so it looks like more substantial. It's a different country. It is. It's a different country than Southern California for sure. Oregon? What's Oregon? Oregon definitely is its own country as well. It's like part of Canada. I'm from Oregon. That's why I can say that. Okay, so yeah, this is the beginning. Revealing the secret walls. And is it open yet? It shouldn't be open yet. Right, it's not open. So we're running the action. Okay, we can let go of the fact. Wait. We should make sure it's not like revealing secrets again. Let's just run, let it run through all these. Open curly brace on a new line? California's a country now? No, it's not actually a country. Just joking. Oh yeah, you were born in Northern Cali? Oh, cool. I love Northern Cali. It's really like home to me because I'm from Southern Oregon, so it's the same sort of hills and mountains and bushes and stuff. Georgia actually is its own country. Good point. Yeah, right? They had to make a whole show about it. God, there's a lot of these. Damn. Just get through it. Just go. Wait, let's just set the breakpoint once again when we get to the other one. Right. There. Now we're stopping all actions. Yeah, I like it. Oh, so why? Yeah, I like having lots of, I like doing my open braces on a new line because it adds more open space around stuff. So I think visually, as I'm scanning code, I can kind of see where things are a bit. It's easier to see what a block is, I think, when you've got an open curly brace on its own line. But it's just a personal thing, you know? This would make this whole conversation even funnier. Okay, so we stopped all the actions on the render component. It should not be getting opaque or transparent. We set the opacity to 55. I guess we could just unschedule all callbacks as well. Wait a minute, only one of these got hit? No, that can't be right. That can't be right. Parallelception. Aye aye. Okay, what happened there? What happened? Oh, let's try unscheduling all actions as well. I mean, all right, that kind of that was a worrisome thing when I didn't get this breakpoint more than once. This is one of those times where you're trying to do one little tiny thing and it takes forever because of complex systems interacting. They made indentation with semicolons instead of white space. That's so crazy. There's all these nops in their assembly code. I mean, of course, you know, all modern compilers hopefully take out the nops. No, you're not a fake programmer. There's no such thing. Come on. Do it this time. All right. Reveal secret walls. Wait. This doesn't have... Maybe this should stop all actions as well. Just in case it's running this twice. In fact, I'm going to check if there is multiple actions running already. Set a breakpoint there. If you can dodge a wrench. Or maybe slap the coder in the face with indenting with semicolons. This is the funniest style. All right, you damn debris. I want you to be fully opaque. This is such a simple thing. Full opacity. Is it using a special shader, maybe? Okay. Yeah, look at that. We only got that hit once. What does this mean? I don't get it. Oh, I get it now. This only happens once for the direction of the door. This gets a door. Yeah. Saves that direction of the door, blah, 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 blah. Okay, so after we open the secret wall, we just need freaking... If dir is not equal to k, dir, none. Thankfully, we figured it out. Yay. Make secrets opaque. Oh, that style that had the lots and lots of spaces and everything was like all aligned. Really? John Carmack dislikes Albin? Check it out. Jonathan Blow commented. Opinions. We got opinions here. Oh, right. The brackets were the ends of the lines. Yeah. Oh, wait. So what's one TBS? Oh, right. This is one TVS. This is the style I used to use when I was a kid. I switched to the Allman style like few years ago. I just feel like it gives me more, what's that called? Margin. It's more margin in the code, which allows my eye feel I feel like it allows my eye to scan code faster. Oh, in the vertical organization? That's wait, what? Oh, is that what it stands for? One true base style, really? Yeah. Oh, and it also implies that you're always using braces. Oh, okay. Yeah. So after we do this, we delete secret entities and also convert nearby entities. I think this is a better place to do it. Delete secret entities or, yeah, delete all entities that match the direction. Oh, okay. That's crazy. One TBS, the one true brace style. I didn't know that was what it was called. Yeah, Steve, this is a really, really good point about that. I guess I don't really worry about it because I don't really need to have secure code that much. You know, it's not that mission critical that this game is all perfectly, you know, can't insert. What's that called? Can't buffer overflow and all that. I know, right? I'm like, I got using Xcode here for a second because I'm debugging, and then I just clipped something into my clipboard, so now I'm waiting, still using Xcode because I need to paste this before I get back to Vim. Delete secret entities. I think this is good, right? We're scanning for all secret components. Yeah, this is it. When you're converting this debris. Oh, duh. Okay, all I have to do here, none of that code. I just need to turn before we start this whole animating debris, we need to stop any current actions and set the opacity and also set the blend func just in case. I think that should do it. Let's hope. Yeah, we don't care about bugs. Kukuriku, that's funny. It's funny that Allman is driving you crazy. I feel like I'm driving you crazy, which is kind of funny to me right now. I feel like I'm entertaining you in some way. Yes, thank God we have freaking fully opaque debris. That's all I wanted. Okay. Now that that's done, we can hook it up to the cactus as well. We don't need this whole check here. Oh, I can get rid of that in entities. playing psychedelic from there. We reveal secrets and also open spirit walls. Opening secret walls requires a door type now, so you can, there's several door types, new types. There's the bombable wall, there's the kill-a-bomb wall, there's the spirit wall, which we're working on right now. Okay, so getting a center point just loops over all the secret components and gives you the center point of them all. I never confirmed that that is actually correct and accurate. I should do that, damn. Okay, so that's the joy of checking over your code before you commit. So you find the little things like, should I check? I should check that, shouldn't I? Yep, I should. Where was that again? Just want to confirm. Oh yeah, the center point of all, yeah. The way I view diffs also makes you uncomfortable. Why is that? What is it about the diffs that makes you uncomfortable? Oh, because the visual merge tools? Oh man, what do you need those for? That, you gotta like open a separate application for that. Whoops. Oh, I stood up before I let it happen. Oh, this is a good test. Okay, I'll sit down again and see if it works this time. Yeah, cool. So now we're bombing a revealed wall, which is a little different. I know Git opens it for me, but then I gotta close it. I'm already in my environment over here. I don't wanna switch environments. I'm that lazy. I don't want to switch. I don't want to do any kind of context switching. As little context switching as possible because I smoke weed all the time. You know? I lose track of where I'm at. Okay, so we're going to get the center point for all this stuff. We're adding to P. Get it from Q. Let's make sure this function works before I check it in. Yep, lots of them. There's a Vim visual diff thing. I don't know, I guess I would be uncomfortable using a visual diff because I'm so familiar with the text diff. I feel like I can spot things real easy that way. All right, continue to hear. Divide, see what we get for an average, return P. That does not look right at all. Oh, and this is actually really dangerous. If count was zero, did that actually return that weird return value? Yeah, whoa, what? Okay, so I messed up that function. This does not look right. Does this look right to anybody? I don't think so. You like the dang piece of code at line 420? What is at line 420 in this file? Dir equals compass dir cast. Oh, see, this is one of the things I hate about Xcode. I've just like jumped to this location. I can't jump back. Oh wait, I can. Never mind. Sorry, Xcode, I did not mean to diss you like that. But in general, there's a lot of things you can't really do in Xcode with the text editor that's not moded. Okay, so this get center point, why was that so wrong? I've really got to fix this function. First of all, we need to check if count's greater than zero so that it doesn't ever crash. And then why? Why did... Oh, I never increased count. Duh. I'm glad I checked this function, huh? That was a totally, totally bum function. It would probably would have crashed people's games on Windows. Yep, you can't mark spots. You can't repeat actions, text actions. Gosh, there's so much stuff you can't do without a moded editor. Chicken nugs. Auto center. This time when we get to here, whoops, not jump to definition, continue to here, got P is all these things, and the Q, the count is 26 this time. Looks a lot more right. Yeah, good. Good gobbly goobity gobbles. So the center is 210, 205. Yay. How did that other one even work with the position so... Oh, the dust was off screen. And the smoke was off screen. Is that what was going on? Is this going to look better now? I'm curious. What the hell happened to the chat just there? Sorry, I lost my chat. I might have missed some chat messages. Run this. Run it! That was my impression of Tom Morello playing guitar. Okay, here we go. We're gonna use this, and maybe there's some smoke this time. That would definitely help this animation. Yes, there was! Oh, that looks so much better with some smoke! That's how it's supposed to be. Let's do that, but this time, let's do multiple copies of smoke and randomly placed throughout there. So, we'll do 8 copies of the smoke each time, and 4... I is 0, I is like less than 4-ish. So the center plus DRANDF times, okay, up to, so DRANDF is going to give us like a random value between negative 1 and 1. We'll multiply that by up to like, say, 30 on, well, let's do 40 on the X. That's 2 tiles. And then 12 plus DRANDF times 30 on the Y, maybe? It's about right, yeah. So now we're doing 4 copies of smoke, all at random positions around the center. In fact, wait, let's do 1 at the center. One guaranteed at the center, oops. And then we got 4 more. We're not using I. It gives me a warning for that. Okay, now we should see a little more random smoke appearing. I can't believe the smoke wasn't even there. I didn't even notice there was no smoke. This totally makes this whole effect a lot more cohesive. Yeah. Yes. I look good. So good, in fact. Man, that was great. I almost want to do that for whenever it opens up a secret wall. Okay, first of all, this would belong in the open secret wall function. So that because we're going to call this from the cactus as well. Open secret wall, reveal secrets and all that. Delete secret entities. Let's make this its own function. We'll call this animate open wall. Gosh, now that I see it like that, it probably needs to be its own anim function. Anims. Animate open wall. Yeah. Right, and then anything that doesn't necessarily need to happen every time should happen in whatever system. Yeah, okay, we'll do that like that. So, we needed an enims animate open wall. Open, actually, we'll call this open secret wall. All right, so we've got anims, open secret wall, and the bomb play sound should only happen from the input system if we open a secret wall with a spirit wall. How do you decide when to move parameters values out into data files? Oh, that's a good question. No, it's not the behavior trees mostly. The behavior trees are actually kind of now, they're more of like a quarter of everything. Let me show you a little bit of the data. It's like, for example, this is a lamp. Here's a lamp. The lamp doesn't have any AI. See, there's so many other things that are data, like all the components. So basically, I'm trying to make all of the components loaded from data. So there's a profile component, and that gets loaded from data. There's a light component here for this lamp. There's a reflection component, a render component, collision component, health component. It can even have children entities. And then on top of that, you might also have an entity that has a behavior and has an AI that does all the behavior trees and all that too, right? So basically, I don't know. I try and keep all the components at least as data. There's still some stuff I haven't like converted over to use data for components yet. But that's usually where I kind of try and do most of the data-driven stuff. I can remove all the enames prefix. Well, I could if I wanted to, yeah. Was I doing that? Yeah, I could do that. But I, when it comes to things like that, my personal style is to keep it. Because if I ever want to go and refactor this code and move this somewhere else, then I would like it to still reliably have that enims. So I'll leave that there. But yes, I could technically take that out and it would be perfectly fine like this. You know? That's perfectly accurate. So wait, this doesn't have secret system? Does not. We need that. Okay. So now we got this open secret wall function. Yeah, so when it comes to like there's like some things where I definitely draw the line, you know. There's only so much data driven you can really do. If you start doing too much data driven, it's like your whole game gets kind of bogged down with that whole process of making things data driven. So I don't know, I kind of drew the line at components, or at least for Songbringer. Components and AI, which are basically components. The AI is an AI component. So the one thing here, though, is I've got open secret wall. I think I'm going to add one parameter to that, actually. I'm going to add a do shake so that I can call this from the bomb exploding or from the spirit wall. And either way, I can say, all right, if it's do shake, then I can do some of these other things like this, if do shake, there. So now basically the default for this function here is that it does dust. We could do dustin for all these as well. Yeah, actually, I can simplify this loop a little bit. So the position of the dust let's make this 5 iterations, and each one of these will do dust and smoke, and then P equals center, and if I is not equal to 0, so the first iteration, we put it at the center. Otherwise, we put that, we add in some random position. So now we're doing some dust and some smoke. Don't need this I times zero anymore. There, and now we can get rid of this. We can call this dust and smoke, and we can call this shake and rumble. All right, we got it. That all done. Good, so this is like a little bit more of a flexible function. Can be used in a couple ways. Could just do smoke basically with the open secret wall thing here. So we're gonna, right, the animate. Should I do the animation here or in OpenSeeker Wall? I guess in OpenSeeker Wall. No, that one. Oh, there's an Anim's OpenSeeker Wall and there's also an OpenSeeker Wall. Damn it. Call this Secret Wall, actually. Just so it's not the exact same as that. That's confusing for the tags. Secret wall, and then yeah, we can do it here. If we succeed with opening the secret wall, then we do anims open. Wait, no, anims secret wall. Do shake false. So there, no matter every single time we open a secret wall, it's gonna do that cool dust explosion now. And back in input system, when we call it from the meditation, we can also call anims secret wall with, oh, we don't wanna do it twice actually, damn. Okay, so I guess we need to call it from not from here. So okay, yes, it's like an optional thing. Call it from here. If we do open a secret wall, then do the animation with the shake here. And other uses of open secret wall. A lot of them. The attack systems. This is one of them. We delete secret entities. Open a secret wall from an explosion. Anims secret wall. False. Don't do the shake because we already did it. Oh, and that's it. Those are the only two calls. Okay. Oh man, you gotta get braces. I hear ya, and you're 29, man. Oh dude, that's crazy. Just funny story, I actually had to have braces for 6 years as a kid. And that's like a real long time to have braces. 6 entire years. I felt, it was gnarly, dude. 6 years of braces sucked. Okay, the last thing is to open spirit walls. Well, let's make sure this all works first. And then we'll do the opening spirit walls with the cactus. Yeah, so how long are you going to have braces? Also, back then, when I had braces, there was none of these cool things. Like today, you have like the invisible align and the clear braces and all that. Back then, they were huge, man. You look like you just had chrome in your teeth. Oh, you didn't have to do it? That's cool.
Good.
I love it. I love that you meditate to cause a physical action like that to happen. Okay, now I'm making sure that the bomb still explodes this wall the same. Good. Right, good. And it has all that smoke that happened, which looks really great there. But it didn't double up any other animations. Like, it didn't play too... Oh, the invisible not might not work. Yeah. Is it really expensive? I didn't know that. Oh, so these are expensive, huh? Yeah. I know, sorry, Dami Killer, but there are going to be more secrets. There's two more secret walls. There's the Killabomb wall and the Spirit wall. Like that were great. Let's just hook it up to the cactus now as well. So when we use a cactus, eat psychedelic reveal. Are we revealing? Oh yeah, this happens every time. Okay, psychedelic, invincible, show secrets. There, we want to do it here. Reveal secrets. Oh, also we want to do one more. Actually, yeah. Why is this running on G's render sprite? Seems really wrong to me. We do... What's G? G is the player? Yeah, this should not run on the players. No, this should be a tick. Schedule before tick. That is what's a potential situation that could have caused it to miss. So basically the problem with using Coco2DX's schedule to schedule stuff is that basically you can unschedule stuff. So this might actually get, you know, unscheduled accidentally somehow. By myself, my own code, I could accidentally cause this to not run. But with scheduled before tick, it's a lot more accurate. And it also is time scaled by whatever time scale is currently scaling. So wait, metal is 1500. But it's clear? Oh wait, no, clear is 2000. Visible lines 4000. Whoa, that is a lot more expensive. Oh yeah, you're not complaining? You have a condition, really? Wait. This is... Hold on. Why am I using schedule here? Schedule is delay, duration, repeat. Gosh, I can't remember. I gotta look this up. That's one little problem with my current Vim setup. I can't look into Coco2DX's source code because of I'm using Rapid Game, blah, blah, blah. It's mostly that I don't have my tag set up. I need to get some tags set up for Coco2DX, but I would like to conditionally use their tags because they're going to add so much tags. If I add Coco2DX to my C tags, I don't know what I'm going to be doing, jumping to. Oh, it's interval beat delay. Good thing I looked that up. Yeah, I could look up the API reference, but I prefer to have the source code though. Yeah, right, just loading Xcode when you need it. So it's interval, repeat, delay? No way. This seems wrong. So why am I calling? I'm calling this every 1 second for the entire psychedelic duration. It keeps on revealing secrets, revealing secrets, revealing secrets. Oh, this is supposed to be L round F psychedelic duration. Over, oh my god, really? I need to set a breakpoint here. This is doing some crazy stuff that I didn't know it was doing, actually. Because I think this is calling this a lot. Oh no, 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 this is okay, because it's L round F psychedelic duration over the this really needs to be more accurately. This would be represented like this. But it's exactly the same mathematical result, so that's why that was working fine. Okay, I can close Xcode. Okay, and now that I understand that, I can reprogram this as a schedule before tick. which is delay 0, interval 1, and count L round F, okay, psychedelic duration over, actually this needs a little interval, const float inter, we'll call this reveal interval there. This is like more accurate. Reveal interval. So there, it's calling reveal multiple times. Yeah, I would say not, right? I have a complete understanding. I went through and had braces, so that's probably why I'm understanding. Okay, so one more tick. This is gonna be open spirit wall. Scheduled before tick. And I want this to run on any area. So if you use a cactus and then you go to a different area, it will still open up the secrets in the new area. And do this, let's see, it shows secrets, no delay, right away. So we need a little bit of a delay before. Const flow delay, I think I used 2.618 seconds in the other file, so let's do about the same there. There, now we've got a delay before it opens the spirit walls using the cactus. We'll see how this goes. Yeah, nice. Oh, Kukuriku, how long is it going to take you? Like, how long do you have to wear the braces for? All right, first of all, if I eat a cactus, it should reveal that wall. And also open the spirit wall. Yeah. I love it. You take an action where you're doing something sort of spiritual, like eating a cactus or meditating, and then it causes a big physical action like a wall to explode. It just seems very funny to me and cool at the same time. Good. Okay, wait. Let's try that again. I want to use a cactus in the other room to make sure it... A year and a half minimum. Oh, dang. Yeah, it's a long time, right? It's a long time for them to stretch your teeth back into, you know, stretch your teeth into something. You can actually, if you actually sit there and, like, push on a tooth really hard until it's kind of a little bit sore, you're actually moving the tooth. You can actually do that yourself. You can actually move all your teeth just by pushing on them daily. But it's hard as hell. You gotta be really disciplined and it hurts. So it's just easier to get braces. I may be talking out of my ass right here, but I think that's what I gained. That's what I learned from my 6 years of getting braces. Is every time I went there, you know, and I met with the doctor and stuff like that, he's like, you know, you could just push your teeth. What he told me. So is this revealing the wall? It should reveal the wall and not explode it. Yeah, good. It's revealing that there is a secret there. But it has not exploded it. It cannot explode it. And if I meditate, it should do the same thing. Shouldn't explode this wall. Cool. Yay! You'll only be missing out on getting the cuts inside your mouth. Speaking of bad advice, right? Pushing your own teeth. I know, right? Why did I even say that? Is the perfect emoticon for that. Can I take it back? Can I take back what I just said about pushing your teeth? I'm gonna pretend I didn't say that. There you go. Yeah. Do they still say high tech these days? Excellent question. All right, this is ready to check in. It's done. The spirit walls work. You can meditate in front of a wall. It's a particular wall, or use a cactus. It will explode. I'm gonna review all the code now. There's the animation. The dust. Attack system has to pass in K-Door bombable when when you use a bomb, so that you're only blowing up bombable doors. Oh, your teeth are crowded? I wouldn't worry too much about it. My teeth are really crowded too. Like, if I try and floss, which I do daily, I hate it, but still, you know, it's like something important, right? Like when I floss, like getting it between my teeth is really hard. In fact, if I don't do it really gently, it like pops my gums. It like go pop and like hurts my gums, you know? So hell, I know what it feels like when you have crowded teeth. Really? So a dentist dude told you you couldn't get them? Whoa. Huh? Wow. You must got some really crowded teeth. I bet you're all right. Take my advice. You're all right. That was a joke. Oh, you mean the Invisalign? Oh, it doesn't work in every condition. Oh, I see. Okay, we can get rid of that. Oh, that's something to do. I need to make sure that. So if I eat a cactus in one room and then walk to another room, it should still reveal the secret. Okay, I'm eating a cactus here. Whoop. Yeah, good. It revealed the secret as well. So that's the benefit of running that as a timer or whatever. So I can go ahead and delete this and this. And you know what? It's probably a bad idea if I don't at least set a breakpoint there and make sure that I did this math correctly. Would be stupid. Stupid not to just check this. Because last time I didn't check it, I almost released a crash bug. Well, crazy. You had a wisdom tooth rotated 90 degrees. I kid you not, I had a tooth growing out of the very middle of my upper palate of my mouth. I had a tooth growing there when I was like 9 years old. While I was doing all that braces stuff, this tooth started growing in the middle of my mouth. I would have been like really weird looking. I had to have it removed. They had to put me under anesthesia to make that happen. Yeah. I don't know if that's like a condition or something like that. You got tooth growing in the middle of your palate of your mouth. It's crazy. Okay, making sure that all these parameters getting passed into schedule before tick are correct. Pretty sure they are, but just to make sure. Cool, we got the function, the delay is 0, the interval is 1 second, and the count is 7. That's great. In fact, one little modification, instead of L round F, I think I'm going to use seal F there. So that if we have a 7.7 second duration, then it would be 8 ticks of that. The forehead, that's a horn. If they put braces on the horn. Oh, is this even possible? Oh, this is supposed to be CLF psychedelic duration over reveal duration as well. There. Okay, so now using meditate will not only reveal secrets, but it will open spirit walls. Also, using a cactus will open spirit walls. Opening secret walls requires a type. Oh yeah, deleting secret entities stops action, sets opacity. Great. That's it for this commit. Let's call that spirit walls. Done. All right. Well, I'm going to wind the stream down here now. That was a good success story there, getting that all accomplished today on today's stream. It looks really good to have this whole animation. Let's see it one more time, this animation. Before I go, I'm going to play this animation one last time. And then it's dinner time. It's Sunday. Sunday dinner time, which is special because it's Sunday and tomorrow is Monday. So Sunday must be special. It's pretty good logic there. Okay, so if I eat a cactus, it blows up the wall. And you can only use a cactus or meditate to make that happen. And typically those things surround things that are important, like this. This is a secret tunnel. Okay, well, that's it. That looked really great. The next thing I'm going to work on tonight is the kilobomb walls, which should be pretty simple now that all this whole secret system and everything like that is all sorted out and the animations are all looking good and the smoke and all that is great. Should be really simple to just implement another kind of wall that opens only with using a kilobomb. So that's it for today's stream. Thanks a lot for watching, everybody. I had fun chatting. I'm glad we got a chat going today. That was fun. So anyways, we'll see you all next time. Appreciate you all. Have a good time.